In this lecture, we are going to see what is circular queue and how to implement circular queue using arrays. See, we have already discussed how to implement a queue, or you can say a linear queue using arrays and as well as using linked list, right? So you can check out those videos in the description box, fine, or in the side button also. Now see, in that video, implementation of queue using arrays, we have discussed a major drawback of the linear queue implementation. So, to overcome that drawback, this circular queue concept comes into picture, right? See, now what is that drawback? This is what a queue. Queue concept is what? It is basically following the rule, FIFO rule, first in, first out. Means insertion would be from one end, that is from the rear end. I am taking this end as rear end and this is what? Front. And deletion would be from the front only, right? And deletion and insertion is going to take order of one time complexity, fine. Now let us take this one example and we are going to discuss again that drawback of the linear queue. This is a queue. I have specified the size of the queue, that is 5 only, right? Now suppose in this queue I have called the function enqueued 5 times, right? It means here I have 2, minus 1, 5, 6 and 7. How we are going to store the data here? That thing we have already discussed in detail in the previous video, implementation of queue using arrays. You can check out that video in the side button. First of all, check out that video, then I recommend you to come to this video, fine. Now this is the queue. Now again, if you call enqueue function, in that case it would show what? The queue is full. So what is that condition? The queue full condition is what? At this time, front is pointing to here and rear is pointing to here. Means in front I have 0, you can say front is equal to 0 and rear is equal to 4, right? From the rear only we are going to insert. So when you will insert rear plus plus, then we will insert, right? Now see, if the rear is 4, it means the rear is this maximum size minus 1. It means queue is full. That is the condition. Now after enqueue operation, I have called dequeue operation, right? Now dequeue means we are going to delete data from the front of the queue. So this would be deleted. It means front plus plus we will do. So it means front is pointing to here, right? It means this is the garbage value now. Only the data between this front and rear, this is now our queue. We don't care what garbage value lies here because we can override this value. Suppose I'm deleting this, right? Now again, if you call enqueue function, in that case also it will show what? The queue is full. Why? Because we have set the condition of full. What? If rear is n minus 1, that means it will show queue is full. Now suppose again, if you dequeue, again call this dequeue operation one more time, then front is pointing to here. In this case also it will show queue is full if you call enqueue function. But we have the space, still we have space, but we cannot insert here. This is what? Wastage of the space. This is the major drawback of linear queue. Now what if we modify our this function enqueue and dequeue operation, and after modifying something, this rear, when we do, obviously we will not do rear plus plus, when we will increment rear, then it will point to here. Now if you call that enqueue again, in that case, now see, this rear is pointing to here. At this point of time, front is equal to 2 and rear is equal to 0, right? And now obviously insertion would be from the rear end, so we will insert here only. Now suppose I am calling enqueue minus 1, so I can insert here, right? And this is not a wastage of space, we are utilizing this space now. Again, if you are saying enqueue, suppose 4, we will do what? In that case, rear would point to here and here I can insert 4. In this case, now rear is equal to 1, right? But now queue is full. So now that condition, the full condition, the queue is full condition, you have to modify a little bit. What you will do, see, in this case queue is full now, but rear is not 4, rear is not n minus 1, rear is 1 and front is 2. How you will write down that condition? See, if you write here rear plus 1 mod n, means size of this queue, equal to front, it means queue is full. You can check. In this case, rear is 1, 1 plus 1 that is 2, mode n value is 5, 2 mode 5. So 2 is equal to what is front value? 2. 2 equal to 2, it means Q is full, and see Q is full as you can see. So you have to modify the those condition a little bit. See now how we will write down this in Q operation and DQ operation coding. So now one thing we have discussed, that when front and rear are pointing to minus 1 starting, at starting it means Q is empty. That condition we are not going to change, fine. So at starting we are going to point both front and rear is equal to minus 1, right. So NQ function, I am calling 2, so here you need something to receive that value, integer x. So now in NQ also we will check, if the Q is empty means both front and rear equal to minus 1, in that case after inserting data here, both front and rear would point to here, we will also increase rear as well as front, means both front and rear becomes 0. This condition you have to check. So one case in NQ function is what? If front equal to minus 1 and rear equal to minus 1, or simply you can say front equal to minus 1, in that case you will set both front and rear equal to 0 first of all, right. So now both front and this rear are pointing to here, and now you can insert. For inserting we will use this one, rear, right. So Q of rear is equal to x. This is one case. Now suppose I have inserted here 2, right, because at starting when we will call this one, then this condition would be true, because at starting both are minus 1 and minus 1. Now two cases are remaining. Second case may be when the Q is full, then we cannot insert. Third case may be Q is not full but we have some element in the Q, right. So now we will check for that case the Q is full. You can check that condition here also, at starting also, fine. After that you can write this condition, it's up to you. Now I am writing else if. Now I have told you what is that condition. We will not write rear equal to n minus 1 in, as we have discussed in previous video, because this is now the circular Q, like this one, right, or you can say this one. Logically you can represent this array something like this, right. Now else if, what is that condition? Rear plus 1 mode n equal to front. Here simply you can print Q is full, right. You can say overflow condition, we cannot insert, and this condition I have discussed in detail in this video only, at starting of this video, why I am writing this thing. Now third condition may be this one, Q is not full but Q is not empty also, it is having one element. Now what you will do? Now in this case we will not do rear plus plus. How you will increment this rear? Because when you will do rear plus plus, suppose rear is pointing to here, and if you do rear plus plus means rear becomes 5, but we want rear would be 0 after that. So we cannot do rear plus plus. What you can do? Rear plus 1 mode n. This thing we are going to store in rear. So simply you will write, now rear becomes rear plus 1 mode n, right. And now you can insert Q of simply rear is equal to x. So this is the NQ operation. See, secondly when we are calling for minus 1, in that case this condition is true? No. This condition, check. See, rear equal to 0, 0 plus 1 means 1 modulo n, n value is 5, 1 mode n, it will give the reminder that is 1. 1 equal to front, because front is 0 but 1 is not equal to front, it means Q is not full. We are not going to enter into this part, right. See, this modulo n condition, this will affect only when rear becomes 4, after that it will become 0. Otherwise same, it will have the same effect as rear plus plus, right. See, I'll show you. Now this condition is also not true. Now else part, rear is equal to rear plus 1 mode n. Now rear plus 1, rear is 0, 0 plus 1 mode n value is 5, 1 mode 5, that is 1 only. So now rear become 1. As you can see, after 0 rear become 1, means rear plus plus na, right. So now Q of rear, Q of 1 is equal to x, means here I can insert minus 1. Again I am calling 5, 6 and 7. For all these three the control would go here, you can trace out this one. So simply we will insert here 5, 6 and 7. And now rear is pointing to here. Now we will discuss first of all the DQ operation, right? How you will write down that code? In DQ also first three cases may be there if Q is empty. So we cannot DQ anything, we cannot delete the data. For empty the same condition, front is equal to minus 1, rear equal to minus 1. In that case you will write here, we have written this thing, but here you will write Q is empty, or you can say underflow condition, right? If this minus 1 condition, then here you will write Q is empty. I am not writing this thing. Else, if, now second case may be in the Q we have only one element left. This thing we have already discussed, I am not going into detail. So if one element is there, in that case both front and rear would be pointing to that element, right? Now if front equal to rear, right? Suppose we have DQ'd these elements. Suppose I have called 4 times DQ, means 4 times 1, 2, 3, 4. Now after DQing 4, front is pointing to here. It means we have only one element left. See, both front and rear are pointing to same, both front and rear are 4, right? So it means we have only one element. If one element, after deleting this element, both front and rear means should point to minus 1, means after deleting this the Q would be empty, na? And what is that empty? We have taken what condition? When front and rear are minus 1, in that case Q would be empty. So here you can set front equal to rear equal to minus 1. That's it. Now the third case is suppose this one, else. And if you want to print the DQ'd element, right? Suppose here I want to print that 7. So before setting both rear and this front minus 1, before this line here you can write printf, the DQ'd element is percentage %d, and what you can print? Q of front, because DQ would be always from the front. So we will use this front, we will not use this rear. Although both are pointing to the same thing, but we will use front. So you can print Q of front, right? Now this case, third case is this one. Q is not empty and Q is not having one element. Q is having more than one element. In that case, simply what you will do? We will, obviously we will increase this front, but we will not do front plus plus, because this is circular Q. Once front reach this point, it should point to 0. And if you will do front plus plus, then it would point to 5, but it should point something like this. So here also you will do what? Now front equal to front plus 1 mod n, the same condition, right? And if you want to print the DQ'd element, then simply before updating this one, here you can write printf, the DQ'd element is percentage %d, and here you can print Q, and so in subscript you will write front. Now see the working of DQ. I have called this DQ here. Now check, this is the Q after calling these 5 NQ operations. Now DQ, empty condition is not true, else if front equal to rear, but this condition is also not true because front is 0, rear is 4. So now we will go into else part. Printf, the DQ'd element is Q of front, means Q of front means 2 would be printed, right? And now front equal to front plus 1. See, front is equal to 0, 0 plus 1 mod n value is 5. 1 mod 5 is 1 only. So now front is 1. And this is same as front plus plus. The only difference you will see when front becomes 4, after that it will go to 0, not 5, right? And that's exactly we want, because we are implementing circular queue. Now this is garbage, so we can delete this now, right? Again, suppose I am calling DQ function. Now this condition is not true, this condition is also not true. So control will go into else part. DQ front would be printed, that is minus 1 would be printed in this case. In this case 2 would be printed. Now front equal to front plus 1, this one. So now front is 1, 1 plus 1 mod 5 means 2 mod 5 means 2. Now front is 2, and that's exactly we want. This is now garbage value, right? Now in this case again I am calling NQ function. Now you will get this thing, NQ 0, NQ 0, x value is now 0. This condition check, is this condition true? No, because front is not minus 1, rear is not minus 1. Else if rear plus 1, in this case rear is 4, see, 4 plus 1 mod n, n is also 5. 5 mod 5, this is 0. Equal to, front value is 2. See, front is pointing to here after calling 2DQ. Front is 2. Is 0 equal to 2? No. It means we are not going to enter into this condition. Means it will not show you that Q is full. Right? In else part, see, now rear is equal to rear plus 1 mod n. First of all, modify the rear. Now, rear is what? 4. 4 plus 1 mod n. 4 plus 1 mod n, that is 5. So, it means 5 mod 5, that is 0. Now, rear becomes 0. So, now in this case, rear is pointing to here, 0. Now, you can insert Q of rear. Q of 0 is equal to x. X value what we have received? 0. So, here you can insert 0. But this is not the case in linear Q. Right? In that case, it will show you Q is full if the rear is pointing to here. Now see, again we are calling NQ function. See, this condition not true. Check out this condition. Rear plus 1. Rear is 0. 0 plus 1 mod n. 0 plus 1 mod 5. That is 1 only. 1 equal to front is 2. No, this condition is not true. So, we will go into else part. Now, rear plus 1 mod n. 0 plus 1 mod 5. That is 1 only. So, now this rear is here. Here. And front is here. Right? Rear is 1, front is 2. Now we can insert Q of this 1 is equal to x. X is 10. Now we can insert here. Right? Now again I am calling NQ and I want to insert 11. So x value is 11. This condition not true. This condition, now check this condition. Rear plus 1. Rear is now 1. 1 plus 1 mod 5. That is 2 mod 5. 2 mod 5 is 2. And front is 2. Now this condition is true. Now control will enter into this loop and it will show you the Q is full. As you can see, Q is full. So now these are NQ and DQ operations in circular Q. Right? You just have to modify a little bit this condition. Rather than rear plus plus, rather than front plus plus, and the Q full condition would be something like this. Somewhere this condition is also written something like that. If this front equal to rear plus 1. See, front is 2, rear is 1. So, front is equal to rear plus 1. That is 2. In that case, Q would be full. Fine. You can write down this condition also. But in that case, you have to write down some more condition for this full. Because in that case, you will also write if rear is equal to n minus 1. In that case also, it is full. So, rather than writing 2 or 3 conditions, simply write 1 condition. And that's it. That will cover all the conditions, right? Now we will see how to display the data. So now I guess you remember in the previous video when we were discussing the linear Q implementation using array, we have discussed how the display condition, we have written what? For loop, I is equal to front and I less than equal to rear plus 1. Till then we are going to print. But here we cannot write down that condition. Suppose I am taking here also, I is equal to front. Means now I is equal to front means 2 or I less than rear plus 1. This was the condition, right? I guess you remember. So I now 2 less than rear plus 1. Rear in this case is 1. 1 plus 1, that is 2 less than 2. No, this condition is not true. So it will not print anything because this is circular Q. So we cannot write down this condition. You have to modify this condition also. Fine. So now here I am writing what? While this I not equal to rear. Fine. Till then we are going to print. See, I'll show you the working of this also. Printf percentage D Q I. Fine. And how to increment I? I equal to, here nowhere we will write rear plus plus, front plus plus or I plus plus, something like this. Increment would be same we have discussed, like this. I plus 1 mod n, because we always want when some variable reach to here, then it should point to here, means in circular motion, and this is the condition for that thing. Now I'm taking I, so here in this function, after in this function you can take I and you can initialize this I with front. Now I'll show the working of this thing. See, at starting I is equal to, we have taken I and I is equal to front. Front is now 2, so I is 2. this condition is not true because Q is not empty. Fine. Else, now the Q is, while I not equal to rear, I is 2, rear is 1. Condition is true. Control will enter into this loop. Printf Q of I means Q of 2, that is 5 would be printed. Right? Now, how you will increase this I? I plus 1, I is 2, 2 plus 1 mod 5. 3 mod 5, that is 3. Now I becomes 3. Fine. Same as I plus plus. Now I is here. I is pointing to here. Fine. Check again. 3, I is 3. 3 not equal to rear. Rear is 1. Fine. See here you can see rear is equal to 1 and I is 3. Yes, condition is true. These are not equal. Again, Q of I would be printed. I value is 3 means Q of 3, 6 would be printed. Right. How to increment I plus 1, 3 plus 1 mod 5, that is 4 mod 5, that is 4. Now I becomes 4, that is here. Check, 4 not equal to rear, rear is still 1. Yes, condition is true. Again, print Q of I means Q of 4, this 7 would be printed. Now how to increment I? We cannot do simply I plus plus, like in that case. Fine, because we have to move here. Now see, is 4, 4 plus 1 mod 5, that is 5 mod 5, that is 0. Now I is 0, right? So now I is pointing to here. Now check, 0 not equal to rear is 1. Yes, condition is true, 0 is not equal to 1. Control will enter into this loop, printf Q of I, Q of 0, that is 0 would be printed now. How to increment I plus 1? Now I is 0, so 0 plus 1 mod 5, n value we have taken 5, 1 mod 5, remainder is 1 only. Now I is 1, now I is 1. Now check, I is 1 not equal to rear is now also 1, but 1 is equal to 1. So this condition is now not true. So now control will not enter into this loop. Control will go out from this while loop here, right? But now the problem is we have only printed 5, 6, 7, 0. We are left with one element still. So now after this while loop here, simply you can write printf percentage d and q of rear. See, as you can see, now control will go out from this loop, printf percentage d q of rear. See, rear value is 1 now. So now q of 1 would be printed, that is 10 would be printed. And I is also 1, so here you can also write Q of I simply. So this is how you can display the data of a circular queue. See, it is not like that. This is the only way to write down the display function. Maybe using for loop, maybe using some other condition here rather than writing here. You can use, if you don't want to print this value separately, so you can use do while loop also. Many methods can be there to display the data, fine, correctly, fine. So this is only the one way out of all the possible ways, right? Now we will see this peak operation. See, this is very simple and I guess no need to write down the code for this thing because this is same as we have discussed in the previous video. You can check out for empty if both front and rear minus 1, then Q is empty. In else part what you will write, you just have to print whatever the value at front of the queue. Means at front of the queue, now at this time 5 is there. So here simply in else part you will write printf percentage d Q front. That's it. No need to do any increment. So this is same as we have discussed in the previous video. Only difference is in NQ, DQ and this display operation. Fine. So this is how you can implement a circular queue using arrays. In next video, we will see how to implement queue using stacks. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.